Hey everyone, this is Sanjay here. Today, let's update macOS Catalina to macOS Big Sur. It seems this is a pretty big file. I will return when the download is completed. As you can see, the download is complete and I have launched the Big Sur installation app. Let's hit continue and hit agree. Make sure you have backed up all of the important information, because honestly, I don't know whether the update would be success or not. I have already backed up my system. So let's continue by selecting the macOS partition and click continue. Then it's asked for system password. Throw in your system password. And here we go. The installation begins. I will come back when the installation is done. This is the usual installation of macOS. As you can see here, I have successfully updated to macOS Big Sur without any issue whatsoever. Let me log in to the user account. Let's hit a continue. It took some time to show up the desktop. This is the first boot into Big Sur. I will fire up the OBS and let's see how it looks. I'm using the same PC which I used in the 8-year-old Hackintosh video. I was using macOS Catalina for past 7 months and I have updated each and every update pushed by Apple. Now I have successfully updated to Big Sur, which is the first major OS update for this machine. Before updating to Big Sur, I was using OpenCore 0.6.3. It took nearly 2 hours for me to update. By the way, I am using age-old HHD and an Ivy Bridge CPU, which is no longer supported by Apple, but the server CPU is still supported because of 2013 Mac Pro, which has an Ivy Bridge E-series CPU. I think this is the last major update that I can perform on this machine. There are not many things to share on the looks. The UI is transparent and there are some UI tweaks here and there. The icons are updated to square shapes as in iPhones and iPads. There are some new things in the menu bar and a new notification panel. iOS style widgets. As you can see here, I have a clock widget and these are two system monitor widgets and some peripheral controls like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and AirDrop and stuff. I have disabled those in settings because I don't use any of those things. Sorry for that. There are many UI updates in the system preferences panel. Apart from that, I don't see much. The major leap is that Apple is transitioning to ARM 64. This is the first operating system to support Apple Silicon. On the Apple event, Apple unveiled the new Apple Silicon devices. It seems to have great energy efficiency and performance compared to Windows machine. No one except Apple knows what is the Windows machine they are talking about. There is no practical data to compare to a Windows laptop. The only way is to wait for the reviewers to get their hands on the machines which were being released in the event. They made pretty big claims about temperatures too, where Apple is known for poor thermal managements in their portable products. This is a great step forward for Apple to become the first company to fully transition to ARM 64. Eventually everything will be easy for Apple because they control everything from hardware to software. So transition for Apple may be easier than other companies like Microsoft. This transition makes the Apple to earn more and helps them become richer. Yep, no more RAM upgrades, storage upgrades, and no word about the eGPUs. They eventually killed Hackintoshing as of now, but they would roll out updates for at least 5 years for the Intel Max. After that, just an 8GB RAM upgrade would cost $200, which is translated to 20,000 Indian rupees. Actually, let me go into the Apple website and just take a look at the purchase page. I'm going to select the high-end variant. As you can see, it is in Indian rupees. 20,000 for 8 gigabytes of RAM upgrade and 20,000 rupees for 1 terabyte SSD. Okay, apart from that, for the similar price, I can say if you are buying a 16 GB RAM variant and 1 terabyte SSD, for the same price, I can buy an i9-10900K with a Vision D motherboard along with 16 GB of memory, a case, a suitable power supply, a supported GPU, and will have some money left to buy an 4K monitor, also a good quality Logitech mouse and a keyboard. What will you do when the Hackintosh is dead? Well, I still have a good machine. I will just use Windows or Linux. I can do stuff whatever I want to do. I'm not against anyone buying the ARM-based Macs from Apple. What they promise on the event is impressive. At the end of the day, you are the one who is going to use the machine. If you have lots of money to spend, you can go for it. This is the first product with Apple Silicon. They are pricing the new Macs lower than or maintaining the same price as like the existing machines. There are no reviews yet. Also, I am not going to buy a Mac ever. Hopefully within a week or so, all the reviews will be out, and then we can get an idea about those Macs and its performance compared to the Windows laptop. Anyway, I will share my experience of using this unsupported CPU Hackintosh after a week. Hopefully the machine stays alive. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If so, hit the like button. If not, hit the other. If you like to watch more content like this, hit the subscribe button. And thanks for watching.